Hi there, my name is Jason Morrell from Two Rivers Software Training. In this video, I want to show you the tricks you can use to make sure that the spreadsheet you've designed and made look nice actually prints out the way you want it to look. Because quite often when you print, the layout's all over the place, the headings that you put at the top don't appear on subsequent pages, and when you try to fix it by cutting and pasting, it all becomes very messy. So I want to show you the techniques you can use to actually do it properly. So here we go. What I have here is a spreadsheet with a lot of data. So if I scroll across here, you'll see it goes across to column Z, so 26 columns. And if I scroll down, it goes down to row 52. So in other words, a fair bit of data. And as you can see, there's a set of headings going across the top and a set of labels going down the side. Now the problem is, when you click Print Preview, you can see that the first page looks okay, but as I scroll down here, like the second page has lost its headings, but it still has the labels. The next page has the headings, but not the labels. The fourth page has nothing at all. And as you go through each of your pages, you'll see that it has a different combination of headers, or labels, or both, or neither. So what I want to show you is the method you can use so that you can make sure that you have headers, like labels across the top, and labels down the side on every single page when you come to print. Now the trick here is to go to your Page Layout tab, and there's an option there called Print Titles. And it displays this dialog box here, and the two things that you're interested in are the rows to repeat at top and the columns to repeat at left. And very simply, we first of all place the cursor in this rows to repeat at top, move the mouse pointer into the worksheet and see how you got a black horizontal arrow there. So we're going to click in any row or rows that we want to repeat at the top. So in this case, I'm just going to repeat row 3. I could repeat rows 1, 2 and 3 if I wanted to, but 1's enough for now. Then I go back to here and choose columns to repeat at top, place the cursor, again move the mouse pointer into the worksheet. This time it's a down arrow, and I'm going to click anywhere in column A to say repeat column A. Now don't worry too much about the notation here, that's just what it does. Now just leave that, it takes care of itself, and that's all you have to do. So when I click OK, and go back to my print preview, okay, and just scroll through each of the pages, you'll see that every single page has headers. So there you go, nice simple solution for repeating headers on each page.